Dear students of class 7, welcome to the online class arranged by the authority of Dr. Khastagiri Government Girls High School, Chattogram. Dear students, hope all of you are fine, safe and sound, staying at home, spending your time effectively with your parents and siblings, and enjoying the online class. Now it is a very serious situation. You must remain safe and keep you safe. Okay, dear students, before going to the class, I want to give my identity. Here is my identity. I am Biplabi Pal, senior teacher English, Dr. Khastagiri Government Girls High School, Chattogram. Here you see my email address. You can mail me if you want. Dear students, it is an English first paper class. Take your English for today book and your notebook and pen so that you can note down what we will discuss today. It will help you a lot and you will be able to understand the lesson. Today I am going to discuss from unit 4 from this book, and the name of the unit 4 is People Who Make a Difference. Lesson 4 and 5, Fixed Price Shop or Morality Shop. Open at page 32, and today I will discuss from 32 to 34. Dear students, look at the picture. What are they doing? You see a man, maybe with his children. They are looking at something, maybe choosing for buying something, and what it is called. There you see another picture. It is also a place where you can buy something, your necessary articles. What are they called? Do you know? Yes, the first one is called supermarket or a fixed price shop. Here everything are in fixed price. There is no bargain. You have to do no bargain with the shopkeepers to buy the thing. You only choose and the price is fixed here. So what is a supermarket? A large self-service shop selling foods, household goods or necessary things, and there is no haggle. Then it is, we can say it fixed price shop. Then it is morality shop. In morality shop, you will find no shopkeeper. So how will you pay? You have to pay the money in a box kept in the shop. Today we are going to discuss about these two shops. So can you guess what is our today's topic? Our today's topic is fixed price shop and morality shop. Open your book, you will see this activity, unit 4, lesson 4, page 32. Look at the shop and answer these questions. Here you see three questions. You will note down this question and write their answer. Three students you see using uniform and also school bag. What kind of things do you find in the shop? Yes, you shop here, you see here. Writing materials, pen, book, mineral water, bun, cake, and such necessary things for the students. What are the students doing? They are choosing, they are trying to buy something and they will buy their necessary things. Who is the shopkeeper? Actually, there is no shopkeeper, you see. Where will they pay the money? They will pay the money in the box. Here you see a box. There are three questions. You see, you will answer them. Now, dear students, before going to the text, I want to discuss with you some new words, keywords. These words are given in your book. You will note down these words, and these words will help you to understand the lesson based. The first one is stationery, materials for writing and for using in an office, such as pen, pencils, notebooks, paper, and envelope. These are called stationary things. But again, it's a verb to discuss prices with somebody to reach an agreeable agreement that is acceptable, that is receivable. Haggle, to argue with somebody again to reach an agreement that is acceptable or receivable. Offer, propose to take or give. Agree on, to have the same opinion as somebody. Suppose I agree with you and we agree on in one point. Price tag. When there is with an old shopkeeper or in a fixed price shop, you will see everything has price tag, a label, a written paper on which showing cost. Consigns, very important of the word here, very important word you will see here, it is consigns, moral sense or sense of right and wrong, prick, hurt, pain, trouble or pierce, morality, it is a virtue, it is a great virtue of moral sense, to understand right or wrong, acceptable, agreed on some or approved by most people. These are 10 words I have written here for you for the better understanding of the passage. You note down these words and learn them. It will help them in your day-to-day life situation also. Okay, dear learners, next, let us go to the next slide. This is from your English for Today book. You look at the page. I'm reading it out. And you then read out, and after doing this, you have to do an activity. Actually, here you see the teacher, Miss Shahana Huda, is talking to her students named Ridoy, Sadia, Sheila, Ratul, and others about a new kind of show. Okay, I am reading it out. You listen to me carefully, then you will read by yourself and then do the activity. Following it. Miss Shahana Huda is talking to the students about a new kind of shop. Shop is a place for buying and selling things. Shahana, you can buy any stationery items here like pens, pencils, notebooks, colored paper, in fact, everything you need for writing and drawing. You can also buy some food items like biscuits, buns, bananas, bottle of mineral water, and some other necessary things. You can also buy your school uniform and other clothes. There are a number of benefits. Means you will find many benefits of this shop. You don't have to bargain or haggle with the shopkeeper over the prices or cost of anything. Rida is saying, what is bargain or haggle, teacher? Suppose you want to buy a shirt or a dress in a shop, in the market. You ask, how much is this? The shopkeeper says, 300 taka. But in many cases, the price is more than the real price. So you offer 200 taka or even less. The shopkeeper says, no, I can sell it for 200 taka. Then you will offer 225 taka and he may still say, no, it will be a loss for me. This process of asking for and offering more and less money is called bargaining or haggling. These two words are new for you. Do you understand bargaining? From bargain, bargaining and haggle. It goes on until you both, buyer and seller, agree on a price. Say 250 taka in this case, this price is acceptable, means receivable to both of you. If there is no bargain, how are we going to buy things? You don't need to bargain because it will be a fixed price shop. So I think, dear students, you have got an idea about a new shop, new kind of shop. Actually, it is a fixed price shop. Everything is The price of everything is fixed here. You need not bargain or haggle. Okay? Now go to the Next lesson, lesson 5. Here you will see another kind of shop. What is this? You will see another kind of shop. It is lesson 5. Open at lesson 5 and its name is Morality Shop. Morality Shop. Have you heard the Morality Shop? Yes. Morality Shop is such type of shop where there is no shopkeeper for taking money. You yourself will pay the money in a box kept in the shop. Read the conversation to know about the Morality Shop. Then answer the following question. You will see some questions here, some activities here. Shahana. You know Shahana is a teacher. Today I am going to tell you about a new kind of shop where there will be no shopkeeper. The price of each item or thing will be written on a small piece of paper. This price tag will be attached to the item or items. You will pick an item you like. Look at the price tag and put the money in the box kept there. I have told you again, in a morality shop, there will be no shopkeeper. Actually, it seems to be strange. A shop without shopkeeper? Yes, there is such type of shop in our school also. This is called Shatata store. When school will open, you will see this type of morality shop in every school. And the thing is now yours. The students are not clear about this type of shop. They know that a shop always has a shopkeeper. You also know it. When you go shopping, you see that there will be a person who is taking money from you. Actually, in a morality shop, no one will take money from you. And they are confused. They cannot understand. Sheila, in that case, someone may take a thing. Go away without paying. Nobody will do it. If anybody does, it will be stealing. Stealing means taking anything for saying not paying money. Ratu, who will see them stealing? Consigns. I have discussed with you consigns, a very new word for you, and you note down it again. I want to remind you, consigns means sense of right and wrong. Sense of right and wrong. Do you know what conscience is? Okay, there will be something in our mind called conscience. It tells you whether your actions are right or wrong. Is stealing a right thing or a wrong thing? Tell me, is stealing right or wrong? Students say wrong thing. Then your conscience will tell you this is wrong thing. You must not do it. If you steal or do a bad thing, your conscience will prick you. That is hurt you and trouble you. And you will never have your peace of mind. So, to be a good and happy person, you should have a clear conscience. All of us should have clear conscience. In morality shop, conscience works as a shopkeeper. Okay, dear students, I think you have understood the passage. You will read the passage again and again for doing the activity. Now, look at the questions here. Look at the activity. You have to answer the activity. The students are confused. Tick, good tick marks. It is your HW. No, it is your CW classwork. Write down the answer in your notebook. The students are confused. The underlined words means they. What is the answer? Cannot think clearly, cannot understand, unable to speak. They cannot understand. They cannot understand. When you buy a thing from a morality shop, what will you do? Pay the money to the office, pay the money later, put the money in the shop. That is the box kept in the shop. Yes, it will be put the money in the shop. A person will, with a clear conscience, usually does the right thing, wrong thing, always gets confused, always does the right thing. We all should have conscience. I also have conscience. And I always try to do the right thing. So it will be the answer, always does the right thing. Now, write these three multiple choice answer in your notebook. I want to discuss with you now the question given here. You will write down the answer of the question. Though it is pair work, actually you will do it individually. You will do it individually. At first, write the answer, then write the question, then answer. Ask and answer question. This is a very important activity. You have to ask question and then answer. I think you remember the passage, the dialogue we already discussed. Can you answer these two questions? Yes. I am telling you the question. You think about the answer. What are the advantages, means benefits, and disadvantages, demerits of a multi shop? You know, a multi shop has no shopkeeper. You have to pay the money after buying the things you need in a box kept in the shop. So, what are the disadvantages? It teaches us the virtue to be honest. We honestly pay the money in the box. It is advantage. It does not need to employ a shopkeeper. It does not need to employ a shopkeeper and pay to him. It is advantage. And disadvantage is, what will be the disadvantage? Goods may be stolen. If you are a thief, if you are an immoral person, you may steal the things. Will you be a thief? No, never. So it is the disadvantage. And some customers will steal from such a shop. They do not pay the money written in the price tag. Now, what kind of shop will you prefer? Suppose there are two types of shops. What type of shops you prefer? You may prefer a fixed price shop or a multi shop. Actually, multi shop, the idea of multi shop is very new in our country. So you may prefer, I also prefer a fixed price shop. Why? Why you prefer a fixed price shop? Think about it. Actually, it keeps the interest of both the shopkeeper and the customers. The shopkeeper does not have the risk of losing his goods. A customer does not have to be cheated by paying more money. Everything is fixed here. The price tag is written on the items and the customers are not cheated. They need not pay more or less. Okay. This all are from this chapter. Now we shall go to another slide. It is evaluation. Let me see how you have understood the passage. I think you all have your notebook with you. I have here given, choose the correct answer. And you note down the answer quickly from 1 to 5. From 1 to 5. I am again showing you the answer. At first you think. Then I will show you the answer. The word price means price, tag, discount, cost. Which will be the answer? It will be cost. Then the word stationery means materials for writing, office material, not moving, fixed. It will be material for writing. The word uniform means garment, cloth, fabric, dress. It will be dress. The word agree means treat, settle, exit, conflict. It will be exit. The word bargain means bring, break, negotiate, neglect. The word will be negotiate. Yes, you see five words and five meanings. So correctly and quickly and nicely write down these words with their meaning. It is evaluation. I think if you can correct the words, you will get 5 marks out of 5. Dear students, have you written down? I hope you all have written down. Let us go to the next slide. Here I have written some questions for you. You have to answer them. You have to answer them. Here you see 5 questions. At first I am discussing the questions. What is a fixed price shop? What things are available in a stationery shop? What is haggling? What is the benefit of a fixed price shop? What happened in a non-fixed price shop? Yes, think about the answer. You can also take help from the text, lesson 4. You will get this answer there. The first answer, a fixed price shop is a shop where there is no scope of bargaining. You need not bargain there. Is a very good benefit. The things like pens, pencils, notebooks, color paper, and in fact everything needed for writing and drawing are available in a stationery shop. What is haggling? Haggling is a process of asking for more and offering less money for things. What is the benefit of fixed price shop? The benefit of a fixed price shop is that there is no bargaining or haggling between the buyers and the sellers. What happened in a non-fixed price shop? Actually, most of the shops are non-fixed price shops in our country. What happens there? There is always bargaining over the price of a product in a non-fixed price shop. Sometimes we cannot buy from a non-fixed price shop because they ask for more money. And we want to want to lessen the price. Okay, note down these 5 questions with 5 answers. And you will also learn them. It is your class 1. It is your class 1. Okay, dear students, I think you have written down. Now it is time for homework. I think you have heard about Arong. Sometimes you need to go there. Yes, Arong is a fixed price shop. Every products are fixed there. The price of every products are fixed there. You only choose. You went there to buy your dress during its festival. Now, write your experience of buying the products from that shop within 10 sentences. That is, you need not bargain with the shopkeepers. It is a large shop and the price of everything is fixed there. You will see price tag in every product and write your experience within 10 sentences. It will help you to develop your writing skill. You may make mistake, it's not a matter. You will preserve it and we will check it when school will open. Date-wise, you will note down your homework. Have you understood the homework? That is your experience. You will say, my experience of buying the products from Arong. In this way, you will write the title and then write 10 sentences in a paragraph. It is your homework. Okay, dear students, I think you have understood the homework. Now, I want to thank you all for participating in the class with great patience. One thing, again, I want to remind you, it is a very pandemic situation. Strict lockdown is going on. So, you must stay home and stay safe. Don't go outside without mask. Follow cleanliness, wash your hands again and again, and follow the rules of health. Dear students, it is time to say goodbye. Let us stop here. Keep well. See you again.